Hey, it's Alexian, and this is your 1 minute inspiration. You might say that a simplified explanation of how magic works is emotion plus thought equals magic. Emotion is the battery that charges it and runs it, and thought is what gives it form. So with one without the other, it doesn't work. But if you have both, things happen. This is why affirmations work if you have an emotional backing behind it. You can't just write down words and hang them on your mirror and expect the world to fall at your feet. You have to invest emotional energy into those words by reading them out loud to yourself and truly believing and encompassing that into your life. You feel it. You feel the love. You feel the compassion. You feel the joy, whatever the affirmation is about. Have you ever read the book or seen the movie The Secret? This is about the law of attraction, which is the basic fundamental law of magic. Now, why am I bringing all this up? Well, in the past, we've had a couple of videos about music and how it can heal you. We talked about rhythm in music. We talked about the harmonic progressions in music. And we also talked about the melodic patterns in music. Well, today we're talking about the lyrics in music. Lyrics are affirmations. Think about it. When you're listening to a song, what does music do to you? It affects your emotions. It either lifts you up or makes you sad, maybe pumps you up or makes you angry, right? Music emotes emotion. It drives you. It makes you feel something. Well, those lyrics that you're listening to, guess what? They're sinking into your subconscious and they're programming you to attract those words into your life. So, if you don't know what the lyrics are to a song that you're listening to, you might want to analyze them. You might want to take a few seconds and actually look the lyrics up on Gugu. Yeah, I love her too. So, this reminds me of when I was at Berklee College of Music in songwriting class back in the 80s. We had to analyze a ton of songs, and one of my favorite songs at the time, I was shocked to find out that it was not a love song. The song is called Kiss from a Rose by Seal. It's a very beautiful song, and I always thought it was a love song, and I'd sing along to it, right? Well, when we analyzed the lyrics, we were shocked to find out it's not a love song. It's a song about drug addiction, specifically cocaine addiction, right? Likewise, one of my favorite artists of all time, still to this day, Cyndi Lauper. She had a song called She Bop. Well, we all were dancing along in the 80s, dancing to it. We're bopping along with her, right? Because she's she bopping, right? The song's not about dancing. The song is about masturbation. Yeah, you heard me right. Now, this brings me to songs that we listen to on purpose. So, after a breakup, a sad song is our best friend. Songs help us to emote, they help us to feel the sadness or the darkness that we're going through in that time. And I'm not here to tell you not to listen to those songs. They help. They're really good for you. It's okay to feel pain. It's okay to be depressed. It's okay to be sad. It's part of the human experience. The problem arises when you get stuck and you don't swing back into the light, right? So you might want to make a conscious decision, you see, to change the song up with a more positive, uplifting message. And you're making a conscious decision to program your subconscious, which will then affect your emotions and bring you up out of the darkness and back into the light. Don't forget to smash those likes, subscribe, and ring my bell so you'll get all of my upcoming videos. Have a great week.